Dai.
Good morning everyone! Today we are so lucky we bump into Victor Mufajande!
Ciao!
Ciao ragazzo, e Victor parla italiano, eh?
Eh sì, un po', ma la facciamo in inglese.
Sì, parliamo in inglese blog. Perché sennò poi bisogna sempre tradurre. Se non capite qualcosa scrivete sotto, eh? So we speak in English because it's the most common language to speak. Ok, Victor Mufajande, tell us a little bit about your story, as your career as a skier. How did you start skiing? Who was in the family, the skier?
No, nobody was skiing in the family. My story is a little bit special.
All right.
Because I was born in Aix-les-Bains. It's in Savoy, but it's not really in the mountain.
Yeah.
So not in the ski world. But hopefully I start skiing really soon at 3-4. And I went to a city ski club. And first of all, I was already loving skiing.
Straight
so
away,
much.
You fell in love straight away.
Yeah.
Eh?
So I went into the competition, and my parents did a lot of car on road to take me to the mountains.
Yeah.
And finally, I'm here. So it's a good story.
It's a good story. So see that even if you come from a city, you can still get it to the World Cup level if you put the commitment, if you have the passion for it. And so then what point do you have to decide to go to a school, to a ski college or something?
So I keep at 10, 11, I keep the first years of college in City College.
All right.
But after at 12, I went to Modane in Moyenne Valley. And at this point, you have to go to a ski college because you can ski one more day in a week.
Exactly.
And I think it's important. So you can start in a city, but after, when you decide, you have to move.
Yeah, so you're saying that in France anyway is well organized. The skiing and the study can be done together. It's not too difficult of a compromise.
Yeah, until 18, it's a really, really good, really good product.
Yeah, that's very important because sometimes the school teachers make it really be hard for skiers because they see them coming after the weekend with a nice tan in the face. And they say, let's ask him interrogation.
you have to go to the ski college.
Yeah, at some point you'll have to go to the ski college. Yeah. And so when did you start realizing that this could have been your career, your life?
Well, you know, it's not easy like this. It's every time step by step. And of course, since I'm a young kid, I want to be a champion. I want to live with skiing. But you have to stay also focused and present. And I took it step by step, and I did like the ski college, and after the district, it's like best guy in the valley.
All right, yeah.
After Comitato.
Yeah.
And when I was 16, I went to the French French pole in Albertville.
All right.
It's like the national center for young guys.
Yeah.
And I went also into the French ski team, junior ski team, and I think was the main step after Europa Cup. And finally, after some years in Europa Cup, I went to the World Cup. You know, I'm more a guy like doing step by step.
Interesting.
And,
yeah.
And not doing like a crazy race and after nothing.
Yeah.
I have to build my career.
We can see also in your results is quite consistent, particularly in Alpine Combine. How did you fall in love with Alpine Combine?
I think it's from the beginning. I was always wanted to be, you know, a skier.
Yes.
Not like a GS guy, not a slalom guy.
Exactly.
My passion is about skiing. I can also doing some powder skiing, some free skiing.
Yeah, this is very important.
All about skiing, I love it.
Yeah.
And this is my way of life. And I think also because of the Europa Cup, I spent some years in Europa Cup trying to do everything. And that's why I built my speed skills.
Yeah.
And I went to Alpine Combine. But first of all, like every young guy, I was like more slalom and GS.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, you all start in more technical disciplines, and then suddenly you realize that Wengen was the lucky resort so far.
Yeah.
What happened with Wengen?
Because I did four podiums in Wengen.
Four podiums in Wengen. Yeah.
My first and only victory for the moment.
Yeah.
I hope more after.
Yeah, so Wengen, suddenly it was your...
Wengen, I started my World Cup downhill there, and I really like the slope, You know, I love also doing some mountain biking downhill.
All right, yeah.
And when I go to Wengen, it's like same feeling. There is the speed, the long turns.
Fantastic.
And me, who is more like slalom and GS, you know, this is more narrow-minded.
Yeah.
And when you come to the speed, it's like a fun time. So
what do you think was your main skill, your main quality to become a World Cup skier? Is it the mental? Is it the technical? Is it the physical?
I think it's in the end, it's the mental. Every
mental
time.
Yeah, exactly.
You have to keep working to love your work, love what you are doing.
Yeah.
Love about skiing, and I think in the end the difference will be in the head.
Okay, we don't wanna. We want to let you work. We might bump into you later on in the day. And I want to always leave a message to some young kids wanting to become one day as good as you. What do you recommend?
Everything you do, do it big. It's my main goal. Every time, keep
go
smile and enjoy and go for it.
Ciao. Nice to meet you. Ciao. Have a nice training and see you
Ciao,
soon.
Grazie. Ciao.